You might wake up some morning to the sound of something moving past your window in the wind. And if you're quick enough to rise, you'll catch the fleeting glimpse of someone's fading shadow. Out on the new horizon, you may see the floating motion of a distant pair of wings. And if the sleep has left your ears, you might hear footsteps running through an open meadow. Don't be concerned, it will not harm you. It's only me pursuing something I'm not sure of. Across my dreams, with nets of wonder, I chase a bright, elusive butterfly of love. You might have heard my footsteps echo softly in the distance through the canyons of your mind. I might have even called your name as I ran searching after something to believe in. You might have seen me running through the long abandoned ruins of the dreams you left behind. If you remember something there that glided past you, followed close by heavy breathing. Don't be concerned, it will not harm you. It's only me pursuing something I'm not sure of. Across my dreams, with nets of wonder, I chase the bright, elusive butterfly of love. Nets of wonder, I chase the bright, elusive butterfly of love.
Diamonds of silvery rain in the fountains and 10-cent red roses from department store counters, watching the moonlight reflect off the river, beside where the trains cross the bridge and slow down. Trains with white letters and black iron sides, and wild rushing water that all rolls away. And little Miss Someone does not want to stay. Everyone's moving with places to go, and Mr. Zero, he sadly stands still. As the water goes one way, the train goes another. Mr. Zero stands still, and Miss Someone don't bother. The present moves out on the sunset's crescendo, as seagulls of dawn set their wings to the air and fly without resting on outward-bound breezes, to die where horizons are melting the dusk. The eyes of the summer are closing forever. The earth takes a breath to prepare for the fall. And little Miss Someone won't pay for the call. The hand of the autumn undresses the trees. Mr. Zero says, please help me up off my knees. Miss Someone is speaking, the world will believe her. Mr. Zero just nods and hangs up the receiver. Oh, yesterday's kiss will be cold by tomorrow, as campfires of midnight dissolve in the darkness. The room is deserted, the blinds have been drawn. Little Miss Someone is packed up and gone. Fast-moving cars disappear down the highway, with signs that say, hitchhikers, do not disturb.
Mr. Zero looks quietly up from the curb. Morning has faded and shadows have grown. Little Miss Someone is on her way home. Mr. Zero stands watching her plane flies above, and with frostbitten hands wave goodbye to his love. Park on a bright summer Sunday, and tapestry kittens that hung on the wall, they all die in the air like a soft minor chord, a vacancy sign and a bulletin board. Mr. Zero is wrapping his jacket around him, speaking kind words that should have been said long ago. But little Miss Someone does not want to know. The night is deserted, there's dust on the shelf. Mr. Zero sits lonely and talks to himself. It's too late to change, the fine line has been crossed. The charades are all done, Mr. Zero has lost.
I told you if I left you, you would hate me someday. You refused to believe me and begged me to stay. Now that your illusions of my saintliness are dead and gone, now that I have fallen from the pedestal you put me on, you're suddenly aware that I have weaknesses like any other man. My humanness astounds you as you realize how real I am. But now, it's lying crooked in your mind. Doll, you should have seen it all the time. Believe me, it told me watching you cry, with no way to say that you set me too high. I should have found a way to make you see I wasn't always right. Someone should have shown you all the colors between black and white. I am not perfection, doll, but neither am I always wrong. Now you tell your friends I disappointed you and led you along. But you expected more than you could find. Doll, you should have seen it all the time. A man must be measured by things that he does. But you look for me higher up than I was. Now that you can see that both my feet are standing on the ground, you're telling everybody that you hate me 'cause I let you down. I wish that you could know that I'm not angry, I am only sad. To see someone so sensitive making herself look so bad. But the foolish have no patience with the blind. Doll, you should have seen it all the time. Doll, you should have seen it all the time.
Now is the glimmering, spinning beginning of something I've prayed for and counted the minutes to be in the shadow of sheltering meadows of night here with you in my arms. Nothing is breathing as sunset is leaving except you and I in the stillness of moonlight. We're tenderly touching in silent caresses, counting on time to slow down. This is the moment that pauses to hold us as you and I move in a background of wonder, surrounded by countless enclosures of nocturnal, unspoken music of joy. Counting times I have stood at the foot of your ivory tower and waited and called out your name by the hour and counted on wings of my heartstrings to carry the sound I have counted on pleading. You see how I need you, come down. And now between twilight and midnight you come to me down in your gown of soft moonbeams and starlight. Bright in the evening, the breezes have fenced us and nestled against us. You're here and warm and mine till the time when the dawn will awake me, the morning will shake me, the highway will take me. But now, while the rays of the moon make the cave, we will swim in the luster of lingering streetlight and count on the night to hold everything even and count on forgetting that I will be leaving. When heaven has folded and let in the dawn, I'll be gone. But now as the gardens of softening nighttime are blossoming slowly around where we are, you and I come together and walk through the dreams of the stars. So here, while the song of the deepening evening is singing to me from the light in your eyes, we can count on each other to move to the beach of tomorrow and know where we've been.
When a city cannot